opportunity to be a part of two iconic movie franchises. One is Barbie and one is Spider-Verse. I've been a Spider-Man fan since the third grade. T's just been a hero, and so to be a part and play Spider-Woman, no less, Jessica Drew, in this incredibly multicultural world has been more than a dream come true and so much fun. It's been, you know, voice work, working with Lord and Miller and the amazing Black director, Kemp Powers, who wrote and created Soul. And that has just been such a unique experience because, you know, doing voice work, you're not necessarily doing face-to-face work with the actors all the time. So you're really developing and creating this character in real time with these directors. And so finding her voice, finding my voice as her, and unleashing that kind of inner hero was a process and fun. And then Barbie is a whole different ballgame. Like, I laughed when I got cast as Barbie because I was like, this is kind of crazy. You know, once it dawned on me that I would be playing a Barbie, it just seemed really surreal because, you know, I thought about little girl me, of course, and I thought about playing with Barbies and literally never imagining myself as one. Even when you see a Black Barbie, it still looks a very specific way. And so putting, you know, my face on that is just, it took some getting used to, and even just being dressed up as one in the movie, because they were very true to the history of Barbie, was just, you know, I was constantly, I was in the mirror taking selfies, just like, this is it. This is what they're gonna get. What led me to invest in Hilltop is a desire for a coffee shop in my neighborhood. I live in a predominantly Black neighborhood, and I work in coffee shops constantly, and I always had to leave my neighborhood to go and work in a coffee shop, and that didn't sit right with me because that meant that I wasn't necessarily working with a lot of people who look like me, and I love also working near people who look like me. I told my business manager, like, I want to start a coffee shop, and he was like, okay, but you're really busy, like, who's gonna grind the beans? And I was like, oh, okay, that's a good point. And so he kept that, and he, you know, found AJ and Yanni, who were working, who already had a restaurant and who were starting a coffee shop down the street from me. Then it was just a matter of expanding. So the next one opened in Inglewood, and their mission aligned with trying to open up coffee shops in underserved neighborhoods. That is especially essential when there are issues of gentrification, and with gentrification comes pushing out the people who've lived there the longest, people of color, Black people, brown people, and then deciding to, once they're pushed out, open up coffee shops, open up yoga studios and the like. And so for us, it starts with the people first, employing Black and brown people in the communities and serving them. Wave of firsts. It's hard to think in first, but I really do. I think about the first way that I'll do something. So while I have not necessarily done a lot of firsts, I've been the first me to do something. And so I think about things in that way and just like, how can I make something unique? But you know, if the first Black woman to own a studio in South LA, if I happen to take that on, that is the first I will be very proud of. If I'm the second, I'll be proud of that too.